Welcome back to Let's Play Song of the Ocean Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. We're here in Kavaro. Just arrived. Ooh, there's a chest there. We, couldn't help ourselves and ran right over to this building and said hi to Mayor DeMille. So we're gonna finish exploring this building and then gonna head back to where we were. If you need any help, feel free to come to the City Hall. I'm assuming that's where we are. Alright, who else is in here before we leave? Secretary. While the mayor was gone to Riatam Island, all the work were piled up. It was a mess. Don't tell anyone that the mayor loves gambling. It's going to change his reputation. Diplomat. I sent a letter to the Embassy of Numeros to protest the kidnapping incident of Mayor and Miss Maritos on Riatam Island. But I got a response that said no one under the name of Ambassador Bereger exists. Do you think it's true? Since I was dealing with Numeros Empire, I couldn't take a strong position. That's why diplomacy is so difficult. No such thing. What's the receptionist? There's a book over there. Data manager says, "Woof! I'm sleepy." Feel free to look at the documents in the data room. But they are all formal writing books. Oh, you know, you can have this book since I've already finished reading it. Oh, nice. Forte and his friends receive a Fred Book 7. Are you sure? Asked Forte. It's so interesting that it will wake you up. The best books are the ones that make you sleepy, don't you think? Really? So he said this book is won't let him sleep. Alright, there's some kind of book over here. Local History 2, Ancient Cedars. Oh. In Ekule, cedars are growing in clusters which are over 1,000 years old. Our ancestors have lived their lives with the ancient cedars. Its characteristics are not only easy to process, but also are resistant to humidity and weight. Even if it's warped once, it returns to its former state. For these reasons, they have been used as building materials and crafts. The Ekule's traditional handcraft dolls are also made from ancient cedars. Excuse me. Adding to its unique smell, the appeal of the dolls whose technology has been passed down for a long time keeps attracting the attention of the people of Weltluna. Okay. I have a separate book up reading that. Well, as long as everything. There's another book there. Town manager says, the elevated waterway is beautiful and convenient, but it is difficult to maintain. It costs a lot, too. We, the employees, are making a great effort every day to make the lives of the citizens of Kavaro pleasant. Alright. What's this one? The Kavaro Times. The joint press conference of the Stardust Cantata, a major event presented by the City of Kavaro and the Maritos Group, was held at the Hotel the Maritos. The joint performance of Diva Wendy and Sid Balthazar, the magician of piano, is the highlight of the concert. And they also attended the press conference and talked about their enthusiasm about the concert. Because of the Dream joint appearance, they say that this concert is getting a lot of attention from inside and outside Marcheros, and many inquiries are being made. That's like a newspaper, like the newspapers we get in Trails of the Sky. Please stop by again. Again and again. What do you want to do next, Grandpa? Says Forte. Well, why don't you guys go sightseeing in Kavaro? I'll take a rest. Oh, he's leaving us? I remember there was a big inn in the south of the city. I'll still be having a cup or two. So you guys take your time and look around the town. When you're done sightseeing, meet me at the inn. Hooray, says Una. We'll come to the inn later, says Forte. Okay, let's go, Jan Rick, says McMahon. Oh, they're leaving too? Oh, damn. Alright, where do you want to start from? Asked Una. Since we have permission, I want to take time and look around. Let's ask someone in the city hall about where we should go. This is the city hall, though, right? What can I do for you? Una says, well, we want to go sightseeing. Could you tell us where to go visit and what to see? Oh, okay. I'll tell you then. The place you can't miss is the International Theater. It's very famous as an architectural structure. It's the largest indoor theater. Many performers around the world come to Kavaro dreaming of standing on the stage. It's literally the edifice of music. Forte says, okay, the first destination will be the International Theater then. The elevated walkway is also the architecture, which is symbolic of Kavaro. They look like a bridge and are located in the north of the city hall. Why don't you go over there? The waterway has been there for a long time. They still irrigate cold water from the north of the mountain ranges to Kavaro. Grandpa Mac was talking about those waterway when we arrived in Kavaro. But Kavaro is truly the town of art. I'm very honored to hear that as a citizen, Rosaria says. Other than that, how about bakery? Bakery? Says Forte. Yes. There's a bakery called Matthew's Bakery, famous for its tasty chestnut bread. Please give it a try as a memory of visiting Kavaro. Some customers travel far to just buy some chestnut bread there. You'll miss out a lot if you don't. Chestnut bread, huh? Let's drop by later. Yeah, it sounds delicious, says Una. The world-renowned International Theater, the beautiful elevated waterway which irrigates water from the northern mountains, chestnut bread from Matthew's Bakery, those things are the pride and joy of Kavaro. Please enjoy your stay. I hope you'll have fun memories. Let's see if they have any ideas of where to go. I mean, I want to hit that chest. Where is Mr. McBain? Grandpa is resting at the inn, says Forte. Una says, he told us to go look around the town. I see. That shows how considerate Mr. McBain is. He wanted to look at the city of Kavaro without any preconceptions. Do you think so? Says Forte. As it turned out, Mr. McBain is quite something. Huh, really? Alright, let's see if everyone says different things. It's awful that we receive requests and complaints from the citizens every day. Improvement of the town, information on the monsters appearing, problems of the swamp. Furthermore, too many numerous soldiers being here, etc. I'm so tied up. There's the embassy of Numeros in Kavaro, but I don't recommend you to get near there. If you need a visa to Numeros, you have to get it there, though. They say hardly anyone travels in Numeros lately. I heard that armed people and dubious investigators are coming in and out the embassy of Numeros. I hope nothing bad will happen. Wow. Very interesting what's going on with them. I'd love to get to the bottom of it. At least that's different. He says, welcome. Feel free to read the documents in the data room, but don't take them out. Please keep the rule. The best place to see in Kavaro is, of course, the International Theater, but I also suggest you the water bridge behind the city hall. Please take time and look at it. A water bridge. Okay, first. Oh. Hello there. Orb of Ocean 65. A marble with the image of Mayor DeMille. I mean, is it really? That's the ones we found recently. I have trouble with my down button. The middle normal. Yeah, whatever. I never look at that album because it's nothing that would surprise you. Like, yeah, we've seen him. How do we get here? We came out. Oh, we go under. Okay. There's a little kid here. I want to start from the beginning. Well, that's not a kid. They all look like little kids. Forte says, ah, something smells good. Something started to smell savory. I guess that's the bakery. It smells like baking bread, says Una. It's the same smell as Alto, says bread, says Forte. Did we pass this on the way here? Fine, let's check out the bakery. I told you, someone is baking bread, says Una. Yeah, I love the smell of bread, Forte says. Headman Matthew says, hello, welcome. Welcome to Matthew's Bakery. First time in Kavaro? Yes, it's our first time. Are you troubadours? Una says, yes, we are the McBain Company. Nice to meet you. You're amazing, despite your age. Forte says, Kavaro is a very big city. Not only is the city big, but also beautiful and fantastic, says Una. Thank you for your compliments. You came all the way here, so why don't you have some of my proud chestnut bread? Are you sure? Says Forte. Go ahead. Una says, Forte, since he is kindly offering, let's try some. It looks so good. You're right. Then, thank you. Forte and Una receive freshly baked chestnut bread. Wow, it's so soft, Forte says. And the sweet taste spreads slowly in my mouth, Una says. I've never had anything like this. Yeah, this is too good. Thank you very much. It makes me happy to see you so happy. Be careful not to get lost. Thank you, says Una. I'm proud of my chestnut bread. I don't think anyone can mimic it. So is it an item? Fresh bread? We already had this, though. We already had fresh bread. I swear we did. I mean, well, we did eat it, so maybe we don't actually have it. Making sure it's... wouldn't be anything under... anything else. Okay. Ah. A second floor. Nice. Very nice. Alright, so this is... otherwise a... dead end? Oh, not exactly. Where's the entrance to the city? This is the entrance, right? Kavaro, yeah. You can't leave. If you go that way, you'll exit the town. Let's go sightseeing in Kavaro, says Una. Okay. Alright, so we've seen the bakery. Who's that? Malva? Hello. Sightseeing? Yes, are you a tourist too? Asks Una. Well, something like that. I'm a trader. I buy stuff which is loaded from Polka and sell it at the bazaar. I just decided to drop by in Kavaro. A bazaar, huh? Says Forte. By the way, did you go up there? No, not yet. Is there anything up there? Says Una. No, nothing too spectacular, but you will understand how Kavaro is working. You can catch a glimpse of people's history. Come over here. Over here? Did you go up there? She's saying come over here. I think she's trying to guide us somewhere. She's come over here, but there's nothing. Alright, so where else can we go? Oh, the stairs. Wyatt says, are you a traveler? Yes, we're on a world tour, says Forte.
Ho ho, going around the world, huh?
Welcome to Kavaro, the city of art. Please enjoy. Una says, wow, these are the elevated waterways, aren't they? Forte says, they look like bridges. The top part is round, says Una. We can't walk on it then. Yeah. It's nice, says Una, to walk around and see the old architecture with only the two of us. You know, Forte...
Oh? What's that?
What? He runs over here. It's irrigating to the outside of the town. We irrigate it from there. What a great mechanism. Yeah, says Una. Humph. What's wrong? Nothing.
And then merge into him. Glomp.
I can't go up there. And then we're back down. A little complicated to navigate. Holly says, have you heard of a violinist of the International Theater named Wolf? His technique is very rough, but he plays... is still rough, but he plays very well. When he plays along with magician of piano, Balthazar, it's hard to notice him, but his sound is sensitive and unique. I bet he'll become a great performer by stimulating each other with Balthazar and leave his name in the history of Kavaro. Okay, that could be written... the last few sentences can be written a lot better. Okay, so Marcha is west. Is this the way out of the city? Oh. If you go that way, you'll exit the town. Let's go sightseeing in Kavaro. Yeah, that's what you said before. So, it's not that it's that big. It's just there's multiple levels. But they drop you off with... at these dead ends. So, alright, that's the end there. Robin says, I don't know why they don't put an S at the end. The elevated waterway is cool too, but I really like these fountains. There are four in front of the International Theater. They are beautiful and cool you off. Oops. I didn't mean to do that. Oops. Can I go straight across and look over here? Oh, I wanted to talk to her. Get back here. If you go that close, I can't go that close. I'll zone. Here. Chell says, I want to be like Bartzel. Bartzel? Says Forte. You mean Balthazar? Really? Anyways, I play the piano. She has an accent, says Una. And I want Wendy to sing for me. My dream is to accompany Wendy with my piano. I'll practice hard with the piano. Alright. So what else is around here? Fountain Boy? I like fountains. The water keeps flowing, and that doesn't make me bored. Right, so they got two Fountain Boys. Lorana says, oh wow, from Dragonlance. You're a troubadour, aren't you? How are you doing? My brother is also a troubadour. He was saying he would head to Graysel because Kavaro's rigid atmosphere doesn't suit him, but I wonder where he is now. Thills says, Kavaro is a city of water. This city's structure is something we can never see in my hometown of Ostern. We're back to the bakery. Did I talk to... Oh, how'd you get all the way over there? Oh, there's a place. Before I go in there, let's just peek. There's like this bridge over here. Oh, that's where we were. Okay. And this just goes behind. Okay. Oops. Alright, so... I'm gonna go visit this house. This old lady. Grandma Coon. My old man likes fishing more than anything. He always goes fishing whenever he has time. Because I always have to wait, I've become a good reader. Since I finished reading it, do you want it? Forte and his friends received Doll Knight 13. Nice. Two books and one episode. He always asks, are you sure? A child shouldn't be reserved. Thank you very much. My old man likes fishing more than anything. He always goes fishing whenever he has time. I'm not completely sure if that was the exact word she used, so I just read it again. Alright, so I definitely don't want to miss anything, but that might be it for this area. And then we go south. Oh, Guardsman says, this is the Embassy of Numeros. The Embassy of Numeros, says Forte. Please leave if you don't have any business. Oh yeah, we can get a visa here, right? Do you want a visa to enter Numeros Empire? You may apply here. Let's come back with Grandpa Mac later, says Una. Okay. Come with an adult later. We will. By the way, do you know a soldier named Palman? What is it, all of a sudden? Palman? You mean Captain Palman of the commando unit? Yeah, he was being called Captain. Hey, why do you know his name? Is there something wrong if we know his name, says Una? No, it's not that, but... Forte says, we met him on the way to Kavaro, so I just wanted to ask you, that's all. He seems busy lately because he's been on a different duty. But this has nothing to do with you kids. Go away if you have no business. Oh, look at that. He blocks us. Haha. Alright, we have to take the other walkway. Thank you. big building. Is this the International Theater? Seneca says, there seems to be no end of young people visiting Kavaro, dreaming of the International Theater. As a matter of fact, I'm one of them. In the end, my dream has not been fulfilled. The most important way to fulfill a dream is to not give up. Unless you give up, your dream won't end. However, once you give it up, you lose the chance. I'm not giving up. I know that it is important to keep trying. Yeah, but are you giving up? Not clear on that. Need to know if you're giving up. I think that's the International Theater. Cassio says, Kavaro's elevated waterways and the International Theater are wonderful, but most of all this city is clean. I have seen many places through my journey, but I feel that this place is made being conscious of people's eyes. Conscious of people's eyes. Hyukus? I heard beautiful singing with a beautiful voice when I was walking near the lakeside. I thought she was a singer of Kavaro, but it doesn't seem like she is. It's too bad. I want to hear her sing one more time. Yeah, we heard her too. Okay, there's a shot. Alright, let's finish looking around here though. Talk to what? Three people, right? Well, there's some. Maybe an item shop there. Hold on a second. Okay. This section has a lot more shops and things. I have a feeling the International Theater is going to be a big thing, so I think I'm going to wait to make that kind of last. What's this place? Height says, I want to be a performer in the future. I heard my grandpa used to be a musician of the International Theater. You're carrying instruments too? We are troubadours, says Forte. Una says, we're going around the world, performing along the way. Really? I've never heard about such an occupation. Yet you knew the occupation was named troubadour. But that sounds fun. I would love to be a troubadour. Serena says, the elevated waterway is convenient, but it causes a trouble of leaking once in a while. Dosa says, so you guys are from Letteratudo, huh? Technically, Marcheros is not a country, just like Letteratudo. Marcheros was formed by simply merging the villages and towns around here, so there's no king or minister. The great elder of Letteratudo is the counterpart to Mayor DeMille in Marcheros. Una says, so, Mayor DeMille is more important than I thought. He does seem busy every day, but I'm not sure if he's important. Oh, don't tell that to him. Oh, we got some kind of book over here. Oh, The Awakening of the Archimony. They really want us to read that book. It's all over the place. Well, we've read it twice. Reha says, I think there are three things I'm proud of in Kavaro. One is, of course, the International Theater, and the other is the elevated waterway. And what is the last one? Well, says Una. What is it? Asks Forte. The answer is Matthew's Bakery. Its bread is very delicious. The chestnut bread from Matthew's Bakery tastes delicious. There's never enough for everyone. Garan says, did you hear that Mayor DeMille and Miss Maritos reconciled? I was so surprised to hear that because they fought like cats and dogs. Pina says, you guys are funny looking. Are we? Says Forte. This is what troubadours wear. Troubadours? I know the performers at the theater, but I have never heard of troubadours. I see, says Una. It seems like there are only musicians who perform at the theater coming to Kavaro. So you guys are performers? I didn't know that.
We're not, we're troubadours.
Alright. Get back here. Stanley says, the citizens of Kavaro take pride in Kavaro. It's good to be able to tell people about my hometown with pride. South Swamp Lightning Warning. Is that where that goes? Oh, yeah. That goes out to the swamp.
Down to the swamp.
Oh, this is cheap. 20 gens. No, thanks. Anyone hanging around? Forte says, huh? There's two McBains. Miss Waitress, I'll dedicate this song to you. Oh, he's playing the song for the waitress. Sun through trees. McBain with his hand harp. He's trying to woo the waitresses. How romantic, she says. And Nora says, you're pretty good, old man. Ah ha ha ha, he says. Cheers on your beautiful eyes, Ms. Waitress. With tea. Grandpa, don't get carried away. Please play it for me again sometime. And the other guy over there looks just like him. Grandpa, the reason why you went to the inn after parting from us was because you wanted to flirt with a waitress? Were you watching me? Luna says, but your performance was pretty romantic, though. When I was on tour with Jan, I always performed like this. I used to go to the inn without any definite purpose and play the music, which will make this place relax. Well, it's too early for you to do it, though. Says Forte. By the way, do you know the name of this inn? No, I don't. It's Hotel the Maritos. Maritos, says Una. Ah, so this is Miss Maritos Tavern? They told me she has her own room upstairs. Then let's go see her, says Forte. Unfortunately, Miss Maritos is not in. She is out for business engagement. Alright. Talk to everybody. Oh, the dog? Is sleeping. It's important to see the city with no bias. Go see the city to your heart's content. And Nora says, I don't like performers of the International Theater. They are snobs and sarcastic. But I love that old man's performance. I was moved by that. I wish my sister could have listened too. Not many troubadours come to Kavaro. Maybe they feel timid because of the International Theater. I hope they will come back more. Well, they will come more, anyway. Any case. Your uncle played a song for me. He said I look like his granddaughter back home. Do I look like her that much? It's not uncle, it's my grandpa. He said that, says Forte. Oh, Grandpa Mac. You have a cool uncle. I will become his fan. And this heart flies out. I saw that. You see the heart? Weep! Oh, this old guy here. Grandpa Yuba.
It's kind of nice to listen to the music at such a casual place. It's a different atmosphere from the theater. The young musicians of Kavaro these days are eager to seek external gaiety. I hope they will learn the deep-toned colors which will make the importance of life, like the performance I just heard did.
What? I hope they will learn the deep-toned colors which will make you feel the importance of life, like the performance I just heard did. Yeah, that makes sense. Alright, bartender. Wow, your grandpa is awesome. This is my first time to see such a wonderful performance of hand harp. Kavaro is a big city. Be careful not to get lost. Not worried about that. I just want to make sure we don't miss anything. Hi there. Musol says, ah, Forte. And you're Una, am I correct? Eh? Says Una, you are... Forte says, oh, you're Professor Musol of the Music School of Cantus. How are you doing? Says Una. Thank you for the other day. Forte says, Professor Musol, why are you here? What's going on at the school in Cantus? Guess what? Principal Forgin told me to study in Kavaro. So I accepted his offer, and here I am. I wanted to feel the history of Kavaro. There's a chest in the other room. It's kind of funny to hear that a teacher is a student, says Una. Well, we never stop learning in life, right? Ha ha ha, you're right. The people need education at any age. Leon also once flourished at the Historical International Theater of Kavaro. I wish I could bring my students. Nice view. Hello there.